Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are the Baker's Dozen. Welcome to the dough days of summer. We at the Baker's Dozen like to start off with a little game we call Hot Spot. And I think it would probably be a good opportunity for us to start this off right. With the summertime hot spot taking us into the game properly, let me introduce the one and only Charles Harvey. Mr. Harvey, we are so thrilled to have you with us as a member of the Baker's Dozen. So get us started right, and we'll go into the summertime hot spot to warm up these pipes.
Summertime, and the living is easy. Fish are jumping, and the cotton is high.
Woo! Thank you.
Catfish are jumping, black water keep pumping on down just the same. Oh, black water, keep on rolling, Mississippi moon, won't you keep on shining on me?
It's a cruel, cruel summer, 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 cruel, 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 that's so cruel, come on.
I'm a creep, I'm a weirdo, what the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. Video killed the radio star. Video killed the radio star. It's in my mind and in my car. We can't drink wine, we've gone too far.
Here in my car, I feel safe in the mall. In my car.
Show you where it's at.
Yeah.
It's probably
a place that would be covered by a sensor bar. Take it to the chorus. Come on, girl, go ahead, get down with it. Take it to the left.
I got sunshine on a cloudy day. I got sunshine, chase my cares away. I got my girl.
Night begins to shine. So don't forget who's taking you home and in whose arms you're gonna be. So darling, save the last dance for me. Ooh, don't you know that I love you so?
Oh, do you love me?
You know what? I really faces at me. I'm gonna tell the teacher if you don't stop. Teacher! Teacher! Mrs. Fleischman, she's making funny faces at me!
Now what have I told you about making funny faces? I'm just reading my book. If you keep making them that way, your face will stick, so don't.
I told her not to. Mm-hmm. See? Ow! Oh! Now you're hitting me? Oh, man. This is the worst high school class I've ever taken.
Okay.
Okay, so if I close my eyes, I can't see it anymore, so it can't see me, right? That's how it works, right?
Sure. But all the kids are still here waiting for you to read them the story. I'm even pretending, so you better get that story.
Mrs. Spicer, when are you going to start the story?
Make sure it's a good one. Make sure it's long so they all fall asleep. Can't pretend anymore.
Is it Star Wars?
It's called The Song of Ice and Fire.
That's it.
Timmy, are you okay?
My legs are stuck.
See, I told you not to get into that rough and tumble mafia crowd, Timmy. How much are you in for this time?
Not that much. 10,000.
Oh my goodness, your mother is going to kill the both of us. And she knows that Daddy taught you how to count cards. Daddy must not have been a very good teacher.
I was trying, but I thought they were only using 7 decks and they were using 8. And I got my aces off and count was off and...
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Well, I guess you're sleeping with the fishes now, son. I know.
Freeze.
Praise the sun! This eclipse is so beautiful. Praise it. Learn from my mistakes. Do not look directly in the light.
I can't really see anything much anymore, but I know it's shining there for me. I love you, sun. I know the sun is up there somewhere.
Look into your feet. Okay. Let's walk over there.
Can you tell me about how beautiful the sun looks? Oh no!
That's something I can agree with. Praise! ding and sing. This is for Ivana and Cam with a special dinger, my wife, Katie Fleischman. Yay. All right.
Yay.
Katie, be gentle with my dinger. it's been through a lot these couple of shows. So the way the ding and sing works is that Cam and Ivana are going to be given an environment based on your suggestions.
Thank you.
And during their scene, as it progresses, Katie will ding periodically, indicating when they need to go into musical, and then they start singing, and when they need to come out of musical form, in which case they resume just normal speaking. So, your environment is a morgue. The morgue, the musical.
I wonder if I can find some living bodies in here.
My vampire senses are tingling. I'm looking at you. Stare into my eyes. Rise up out of your bed. Look right at my head.
You are
right, that's a good spot to stop. I think we have a little bit of a framework for the scenes to go. So which genre would you guys like to do first? Sci-fi and then Shakespeare? Sounds good to me. So the sci-fi Weight Watchers meeting.
Welcome to the starship. What can we do with you today?
I'll have a little bit too much booze. Help the corridor with the rat, or the corridor with the opening door that draws the tiger.
Well, depending on how much you want to lose, the ka-chak-ka-chak-ka-chak would really help.
I'm so excited to have you here. Thank you for coming. It's been
quite the week, so I feel like we should just get started. I'd like to take some questions. Does anyone who has anything they'd like to start with, please feel free to go right on ahead. Yes, you.
Hi. Spencer Trace from Mother Jones. I just want to know what's going through your mind right now.
Well, we couldn't be more excited with this development. Looking so much more forward and in the eyes of the press, we're thrilled. Yes.
Yes, Susie Jones from America Magazine.
Yes.
I'd like to know if this was planned.
We like to keep our disclosures out. We're a full disclosure entity, so of course, you know as well as I do that this took us by surprise.
I understand. Thank you, sir.
Now, was this a foreseeable thing that happened, or did it happen spontaneously?
Well, in this industry, we like to keep our plan, but we don't really want to let you know. We hate to ruin the surprise. So, you know, in reference to the last question, you can kind of draw your conclusion from that.
Yes. Yeah.
With the deep accent voice.
Yeah, don't make fun of my Australian accent. I am the former governor of California. Hello there. All I want to know is if I'm going to get royalties for my, you see the movie with the little guy? Hello, it's a very similar storyline.
As much as we may have copied or used your likeness, unfortunately, it is a unique production.
Thank you. I'm going to go tweet at the download.
When you get in front of the press like this, sometimes you gotta take everything into consideration. You know what I mean?
That'll be for sure.
Fallon Struthers here. Are you the first of your kind?
Well, it's a big leap for mankind. Yes, can I take your question?
I'm sorry, I'm with Nat Geo, and I'm just trying to understand physically how it's going to happen. I mean, there is no port of exit. Well, there is, but oh my!
But what, sir? What? Are you trying to advise
me? I'm gonna go be sick.
You know, if people like him that don't have an open mind about trying new things.
National Geographic magazine here. We would like to film the entire process. It's just amazing.
Well, we're a big fan of reality television. We'd like to participate in that, and you'll be able to meet with our lawyers after you.
Hey, I'm a representative from Target. Have you started a registry yet?
Well. We'd like to prepare, we don't have the gender, so we're going to go ahead and hold out.
Wonderful. Why are you calling
I just want to thank you all for being supportive of me being the first man to give birth.
Suggestion sheets, and we'll go right on to the next game. Next game is Slow Mo Olympics. And this is a game for. Ivana and Corey are our athletes. Graham and Hope are our commentators. So, the way that Slow Mo Olympics works is that Corey and Ivana are participating in a fictional sporting event based around a household chore or activity. The only catch is they are going to be participating in set effect or game in slow motion. So, Graham and Hope are going to be tasked with giving you the play-by-play and color commentary of this Olympic event. The event is ironing. Ironing your clothes. Something Corey knows all about.
ladies and gentlemen, and we are here once again with the Ironing Championships here on ESPN4.
Yes, today's going to be a very eventful day. As you can see, we have our first man competitor of 50 years coming in from our
It really is. I'm glad that I wasn't the one to break that glass ceiling.
Well, we can tell it's not like that
beer strong. Anyway, let's go back to the competition, shall we?
In an interesting choice, now these contestants have been applied to Canadian rules. And as you know, Canadian rules means that yes, you can bring your own ironing board. As you can see here, we have our two contestants. We have Ivana, who seam work. She's going right up the seam. Now, there's a lot of controversy about the seam work.
Seams are important. You want to get that crease perfect. Oh, look at that. Look at that seam work. The seam work and the seam work. Oh, this girl, she's got it all going for her today.
Corey, taking a risky choice, going with the corded iron.
Yes, a corded iron hasn't been seen here in 10 years. So she always worked out there.
Oh, he's having trouble with the electricity. ESPN4, the bills don't get in as paid as well as ESPN3.
see Ivana slowly inching closer and closer.
She has that fabric softener. What's she doing with that?
Oh!
Oh
no, she just soaked his entire shirt.
Apple cider vinegar is not going to get that out. Let's freeze frame this here for a second. He is presenting it.
To her.
Thank you. Now, wait at it. Now you can see the drips coming off of it. And I'm just going to do a little John Madden here. You can see right here.
You can see her face frozen in fear as the fabric softener drenched her comes closer to her head.
You know, I think we need to reverse this, and I want to see the point of impact. So we're going to reverse this real quick. All right, reverse. All right, let's speed up this reverse a little bit, though. Faster. And let's freeze. And right at this moment, you can see Corey's hopes dashed. In all my years of commentating on ironing and cleaning apparel, I have never seen this since the Kwan incident of the Laundromat Olympics.
There's a reason this was banned in Canada.
But Canadian rules are very liberal with retaliation. On her face! Let's all be thankful that they are required to wear safety goggles. Did you hear the alarm? Oh, these contestants have 30 more seconds. 30 more seconds. Oh my goodness.
Right.
This is really crunch time here.
So
the power just kicked back on. No! The Russian jumps were just hit by the iron. The irony. We're coming in. Let's get a countdown. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. 3, 2, 1!
Alright, now we're just gonna pause and we're gonna inspect their shirt. You see, Ivana is clean, crisp. Look at those sleeves. Those are beautiful. Not a single damp spot left. And then.
Ooh, we go over to Corey's. Now he's, again, that glass ceiling, that could hurt him. Oh. The Ugandan judge is not looking pleased. That fabric's off. But wait, oh, I think Corey had a trick up his sleeve, or rather, in his pocket. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't believe it. Are you seeing what I'm seeing, Hope?
He has another shirt.
The old Chicago switcheroo! The judges have announced. Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time ever, a male winner!
Congratulations, a male
deconstructing gender stereotypes whenever we can. That's just an added bonus here at the Baker's Dozen. So next up is a game called ABC. This is for Katie and Cam. The way that ABC works is that Katie and Cam are going to be given a location for the scene that they are going to be participating in. They're also going to be given a letter. With that letter, they need to begin the first line of the scene and respond accordingly with each successive letter of the alphabet. So the line is, can you help me? The second line might be something like, well, do you want me to lift it for you? So they work through the alphabet, the end of the alphabet being the trickiest, and build a scene based on that. So the location that you guys have, the ball pit at McDonald's.
Ew.
Yeah. You don't both have to be in it, but just play like a ball pit. However you like it. And your letter, your letter will go with C for Kim.
Kathy, are you ever going to come out of there? I
don't know yet. I want to keep playing.
Every other kid has already gotten out.
Frankly, I don't care.
Good.
Song in this hard, guys. You tried. Let us see here. Ivana, you are a calculus teacher. In part because I think my calculus teacher is in the crowd tonight. Hope, you are an undertaker. Oh. And Kylie, you are a cult leader. Are we good with these? Let's bring Charlie in.
Thank you.
a little more information about these three.
Oh, no, I think I figured these facts out myself. Bachelorette number one strikes me as maybe a math teacher or professor.
Kelly.
Number two seems to be way too enthused about being a medical examiner. And the crazy kinky girl number three, I do believe is a cult leader. None of them, because I only date Klingons!
Bravo! All right. One final game before a brief intermission. During the intermission, we invite you to go enjoy some concessions, some coffee, some tea, whatever suits your preference. But we have a little something special planned for you. First of all, we'd like to extend a special thanks to our prop master general and theater guru, Mike Lipsitz. Thank you very much. So, let's go ahead and bring out the props.
Oh, Mike, we already have them.
We got a mic.
Thank you. Yeah.
Always working. Sit down and enjoy the show, Mike.
Okay. Some of these, detached, the troop have never seen these props before.
Too tight. Oh, here's your snake. Oh, I need
the greatest things.
He made Mickey Mouse.
And he didn't wear a ring.
His empire spread from coast to coast.
It went across the land.
And then when it came to California,
everyone cried when Bambi's mom got shot.
And now we're fairly dozing.
He made us the Jungle Book.
I want to see them all.
He made a lot of great things.
And now he owns them all.
But let me tell you something
about those things he wrote.
All the classics he has made.
And the box office that he's broke.
He made an amusement park.
He made one too in Florida.
And that spread around the world.
And and wonders he'd have told you. Oh,
Math. Remember in The Lion King,
when Simba's dad was dead.
Might have even shed a tear.
And Scar's scar was red.
That guy named Walt, he owns it all.
And now, me and you.
Only thing that is a problem
is when I eat a Charleston tune.
Oh,
Joe and Amy are actors and actresses in a foreign film, except we have no idea what they're saying because they will be speaking in gibberish. However, we have the intelligent Kylie and Corey here to perform our translations for us. So after each line of dialogue, each of these actors will translate what is happening in the foreign film. The title of your foreign film, Return of the Plumber.
Hello, Mr. Plumber.
Oh, Shabunga.
Well, thank you. Greetings.
Can I show you my bathtub in my bathroom?
Can Diamond just, yes.
Well, if you insist.
All right, now follow me through my very dirty home.
Composta.
Man, you're not supposed to put compost in the toilet.
Down the toilet.
scents? Will it make my toilet smell clear?
Have you heard of potpourri?
Thanks! All right, next up is a game called What's in the Bag? This is for Cody and Pope. So Cody is going to be returning an item that he bought at Pope's store. However, he has no idea what's in the bag. It will be up to Pope to clue him in on whatever clue she can give him. Or if she just wants to toy with him for a few minutes, that's fine. So, the item that Cody is returning, if he is out of earshot, good. Cody is returning a dragon egg.
Yes, I'd like to return this.
Excuse me, ma'am. I am I supposed
I think I need some help.
How did you swallow the knife? I'll check with it.
Well, you see, I'm a sword swallower in training, and we were training with some knives. And my my coach, she gave me a bit of advice. She said, get off your cell phone, but...
Thank you.
how long this lasts.
See, funny story, the first time I ever met the bride, we were actually both naked.
And I just want to say, I'm sorry that we messed around that one time in Cancun.
All right, bro. Enjoy your bride. You didn't work out with us, but hope it worked for you.
Oh.
I'd like to make a toast to my friend, the groom. Please don't sleep with her sister like you did last time.
I'm sorry. I brought actual toast.
Take it.
The happy bride and groom, they truly do say third time's a charm.
All right. World's worst example of a batting ritual.
I'm gonna just do the rest.
That's what the guy does before he goes into the batter's box.
Okay. Every time. That's why baseball's 4 hours long. It's Velcro.
Okay, you just have to spread your wings and fly! Fly! Into the night! No, sorry! Into the night! Oh, Mike Python, it's Channel 3.
naked and afraid of the dark. World's worst magician.
And now I will take out of the hat a...
And presto, change-o, poof, your credit card's been charged $500.
Well, since I'm out of pumpkins for my pie, bippity boppity boop, bip boop, bip boop. Christmas. Oh yeah! I forgot Christmas is every day!
called Dr. Know-It-All. The way that Dr. Know-It-All works is that Charlie, Joe, and Lisa are going to be a three-headed expert. And I'm going to ask our three-headed expert some of life's burning questions.
Sure.
Expertise comes in all shapes and sizes, y'all. It's all good. So the only catch is they can answer one word at a time. So, Dr. Know-It-All, it's a pleasure to have you here. Your first question is one that I think the audience will find practically useful. Where do all the left socks go?
Well, the
left
drawer, all
and
smelly,
disappear
into
the
internet.
Oh, that makes sense. Very good. Dr. Know-It-All, if cows ruled the world, would they drink human milk?
Vitamins
and
soft
cum.
Sometimes.
Don't
coincide. Given
moment.
Oh.
Ha ha ha!
Cam and Amy back to Katie. We're going to ask them in order in the sequence what the environment was, what the occupation was, and what the murder weapon was. In the case that they get it right, we let them know with a nice polite round of applause, like so. And if we get it, if they get it wrong, then we let them know nice and loud.
No!
So, Cam, what was the environment?
Not the house.
Yay! The short one, we're pretty happy to introduce. This one we haven't played before. We are doing a game called Hoedown. So the way that Hoedown works is that Charlie, Graham, and myself are going to be singing a Hoedown for you guys based on one of your suggestions for a personal problem that you would like to keep secret. So, let's see here. Flagellants. It's not really a secret. People in the corner are going to test for it. Bad wedding. Oh, we wet the bed. Oh, there's a sore spot, Graham. Oh, the bed wedding hoedown. Yeah, but we'll do it. Okay. Ba 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 ba. I have a little problem, I have it every night. It's reason my mommy and me always have a fight. I always make my bed sheets really dirty. The problem is I'm nearly 30. My wife tells me a problem I really have to commit. She tells me that all these sheets don't fit. Reason that they happen, I have to disclose is that I'm peeing all through my clothes. I don't like my kids, they always leave me alone. They shove me in this godforsaken home, so I get back at them the only way I can. So I refuse to pee in anything but my bedpan. Anything but my bedpan. It happens to everyone, all right? Take it easy. Our final game, last line jump and freeze, and this is for everybody. Kylie and Corey are going to start us off. And the way that last line jump and freeze works is much like regular jump and freeze, which you guys saw at the beginning of the show. In addition to taking the previous part or the previous player's positions, though, the new scene will incorporate the last line of the previous scene as the first line of the new scene. So we're going to give Kylie and Corey a first line. Your breath stinks.
Your breath stinks. I can't tell you this enough. You really need to brush your teeth.
Is that really the reason you won't kiss me?
Oh. Yes, that's the reason. Yeah. I'd like to have all these like comic books and stuff.
You've been so distant lately. Honey, I'm just worried that we're not as close as we used to be.
Yeah, that's because of your breath.
it's the really problem, huh?
It's one of the problems. There's many.
Freeze. Yeah.
There's many.
Well, I know there are. That's why I brought them. I know.
I'm worth more than a blood diamond. Oh, this is kind of like two carats.
2, that's 20. 20 carats.
That
it's
enough.
Worth $15 million. Yes, look.
Okay. Yeah, all right.
Now,
okay.
I...
Thank you. Thank you.
I guess.
Yes, thank you.
Please.
Thank you. Thank you. I don't know what I would have done if you had not come along.
Yeah, well, this blessing is going to cost you $1,500. Okay.
Do you take Visa?
Actually, yes, I do. I hollowed out a Bible just for that very reason. Actually, I got a credit card machine right in it.
Well, that's an old-fashioned one. I haven't seen one of these in 20 years.
Right, God bless America. There we go. All right.
Now, will this absolve me?
It's going to be a little bit of a process. You know, kind of like how in the Catholic dogma you have to do a couple little things to show Jesus that you're worthy. You know, to... Yes, yes. Just like with our church. Right? Okay, so part of it is that you get blessed by me. Remember. There's a reason why you got the premium rate. Sorry.
There's the reason why you got the premium rate. No wonder. Well, we need to get you in the gym so you can inspire all of our other clientele. Mm-hmm.
You know, the first 100 pounds I shed really was the journey, and I'm just thankful. You guys are here for me.
You know, that's why we got to offer this discount. The improvements that we've seen out of you are going to inspire so many other people to join Weight Watchers and come to our gym.
Money! What did you do?
I'm sorry.
What did you do to my
husband? I didn't make some...
Yeah.
a sewing room, weight room, and we got a kitchen. Right. And, you know, I just figured it was time, you know, I've been watching the news. And,
right.
You know, and so, and you folks can come and visit. There's a tunnel.
That's great. I can't believe you were so considerate to think about your in-laws, too. That's so sweet. You know, the world might be falling to crap, but at least we still have each other.
We'll be together.
Another special thanks to Mr. Charles Harvey. And we are the Baker's Dozen. Come join us again next month for some unscripted hilarity. Troop, take a bow.